Hello, people! And I know I was just recording not too long ago, but I decided since there apparently is two demos for Thief the Dark Project, not the Thief Gold Edition, mind you, but Thief the Dark Project, I might as well do both right about now, because it is a very convenient time to do them. I might even do the Thief the Gold one. I'm not sure if I'm gonna wait on that one or not, but I definitely want to do both Thief the Dark Project demos around the same time. And since it seems like I have time or whatnot, I'm going to try and bang this one out. We'll see how this goes. But I don't have to give in too much introductions this time. I can get right underway. There we are. That. Now I want to check and make sure everything is set up properly. I have to make sure I don't have multiple CPUs in use right now, so that way I am not risking my game freezing. And that's similar to last time, not supporting the demo version. And one more second, I'm going to copy over my keybinds, as I just installed this one. I haven't even really been able to play it yet. I was so excited about just getting right to it, so I wasn't thinking about what I was doing. And now I'm going to copy and replace that. Whoops. Let me change that back. That should be good. And I believe, let me actually check my control, see if that actually be beautiful, if that made that work.
Left, right.
Sorry about all this, people. I have to make sure everything's set up properly. Me actually stop the game. Just that way I can make sure everything's set up in the options properly. Because now the resolution's gonna be right, everything's gonna be right there, and there's going to be my side right is wrong. I think maybe because I was in game and I did it. Okay, so I'm gonna try and this time transfer everything over from my user bind properly, aka from a closed position, not an open position. And now when I go to my. Also, the introduction once again is saying not supporting the demo version. Credit saying it's not supporting the demo version. So it's very similar to the first demo. Not at all a surprise. And now everything seems to look right to me. So now I can actually change my setup and hope everything's functional. The first part seemed to work fine by doing what I did, so I'm going to do something very similar for this one. Just bang out these two. Oop. This one around, we get, interesting. We actually get two buttons, because that's how the mechanics of this works, is that you'd have the play tutorial and then the regular mission. But both buttons are going to go to the same area, start demo. It's very interesting because that's how some fan missions end up working. I thought that was just a limitation of the fan missions part, and that if Looking Glass is to do it, they do it different. Apparently not. Even Looking Glass, when they did the demo, they did a very similar thing where one was just the start demo button and the other was black, and both lead to the same area. So, very interesting to see that mechanic used here. Alright, so similar to what we got in Lloyd Baffert's, we get a textual introduction, not a cutscene. Flush with cash from a big score, you head off to the shop of Farkas, a shady local merchant. Farkas is one of the few who will sell to an independent operator like you without knuckling under the pressure of corrupt city wardens. From Farkas, you can obtain a new set of lockpicks, with which you plan to make pay. Make a play at the local Hammer Temple. And all that seems pretty clear. Exactly the same as before. Map looks the same. And this level, I'm a bit more rusty on what exactly you can buy, but I'm not seeing anything too out of the ordinary here, luckily. So I'm just gonna assume it's pretty similar. interesting. When we try and buy something, it doesn't even make the sound like I'm buying something. It's just you hearing the button press. Yeah, I actually want more moss arrows then. I'm going to get a few moss arrows because I know how this level plays out. Okay, so that was, sorry, 7 moss arrows, 6 water arrows, 41 broadheads, lockpicks, and lockpick instructions. And it even gives us our same textual stuff for the lockpick instructions and whatnot. But I said not surprising because they didn't want to change too much stuff around, apparently. I'm really curious how much of the level are we going to play. Are we going to really see the entirety of this level? You saw how it went backwards. We made it pretty good distance. All of a sudden, we were basically ripped off on seeing the end. I'm curious if here we're going to be kind of cut off before the end. We'll see. Where's this mission going to start me? In Farkas's shop, of course. Surprising after the last one, but then again, they did give me the narrative of Farkas's shop. Okay, I'm seeing my game is functional, so I'm just going to assume it is. And we're going to go underway. This place looks very similar to the final version. So far, so good.
That shot was meant for me.
This goblet's missing a texture.
Yes, look at that. I'm sure it was Garrett in the window. He's dead. Let's head back now.
That's interesting.
These creeps are going to lead me right back to whoever sent them to kill me. But only if I can tail them without them noticing me.
That goblet's missing a texture. That's very interesting to say the least. Beyond that, I'm not seeing anything out of the ordinary in here. Just want to check everything quickly. Gotta hurry after them. They're right heading down the street. Friendly assassins. Is it just me or is their model look somewhat different? Like they're more skinny or whatnot. They look different. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I swear the assassins look different in this version. Like, more blocky, almost. They're gonna be going left. So we know the route. We've done left before, that's actually what I did in the final version. But by now I kinda know all the different routes around here, and how to handle them. Look over here. I swear, these guys look different than they did in the final version. That is not the assassins I've seen. I should know, I spend a lot of time looking at their back. Very interesting, to say the least. We get our old friend the Switch in here? Yes, we do. Aha, look at that. And similar to the last one, I'm not going to go too far into explanations. This is a replay of Assassins more than a first-time playthrough of it. So it's more of a let's check things out while we're here type thing.
Don't see anything now.
But very interesting that the Assassins look so different. Like I said, that's definitely something that's odd to my eyes. Because they're so blocky. I can see why they changed them. Wonder if that was the Thief the Dark Project, the Thief Gold, that they changed that.
Stop. Is someone following us?
Alright, we're doing good. Trailing these assassins. Interestingly enough, we haven't seen anyone in the streets, so this way usually we don't anyway. So, sadly, I'm not going to be able to check that this time around. Is that water always still in the final version? I don't remember that. Looking like that. That static. It looks weird to me. Usually I think there's some movement to that water. Weird. Looks a lot more stagnant here. Could be wrong, could be stagnant in the final version. My memory isn't as good in this level as it is in Wood Baffert's, but these guys definitely look funny to me.
You heard someone back there.
The final version of Thief Gold looks weird.
Nothing there now.
Look at the original look of the assassins. Look how funny their legs look.
So, these are Ramirez's boys. I think it's time I dealt with Mr. Ramirez once and for all.
Alright, everything sounds like it's the same. Okay.
If Yorick tells me the hammers are gonna close down Craig's left.
Yeah, he's tapping you. Where are they gonna put the poor saps they grab?
Dunno. Toss them into a well or something. Anyhow, they just don't have enough guys no more.
Kinda sad. Used to be the power. Now they're just a bunch of guys wishing for the old days.
Show yourself.
One way to take out two of them. Nice buddy system. Similar to the last one, I'm probably going to be taking more risks as I've already iron-moded this mission. More of a, let's check it out while iron-moding. That's probably from my previous video getting uploaded to YouTube. I don't know, this water just looks so static to me. It's weird. Anyway, let's wander around the city aimlessly. Funny hop even to get a little bit faster around. That's something I never get to know when we show up. This area is pretty much the same. And do I feel like going around the entirety of the city? Yes. Yes, I do. Most likely, if all the city exists, most likely the go-home objective probably will exist. Which means this one's a lot more similar to the final version, ain't it? Already checked it all that way. Statue area. Four waves. Use this one. Cut across. Down here. Up the ramp. That way we send the statue areas. I continue heading this way. All this way down. Do-do-do-do. Oop. And down this intersection. Down this way. If you notice, the sewer doesn't have its entrance. Oh wait, it would be over here. And it does have its manhole entrance. Never mind. Was that always there though? I don't recall that being open before. That looks interesting to me, because I do not recall that in the Thief Gold version. The water looks funny too, like an odd coloration. I might be wrong, but this water looks funny to me for some reason. Maybe it's just, like I said, oddly colored water. If something feels funny to me, there's probably some reason for it feeling funny. Most likely it's something that is different. Alright, let's head down here. This way! Get back to these back ways, I might as well come down here and then return back. See where the machine works. I've always been curious to see what's up here. Absolutely nothing. You notice it's just space on the other side. But up unlike the Lost City, us all. Garrett's neighborhood. Okay, this area looks pretty much the same as the final version. I think this is where the segmentations all would be. Of course, this machine room not appearing in the final version of the Lost City. But apparently, all of this made the demo, surprisingly. Only real difference was the shape of the assassins. Some other things which might or might not be the case, I'm not sure. I'm gonna comment on them, and who knows, maybe someone will actually be able to point them out. You know, be more attentive to detail than I was for this mission. Like I said, Assassins is one of those levels that I don't have as good as a memory as some people do, probably. I'm more of a Thief 2 person that could tell you these type of details. It's all that way. Over here, nothing over here. Just move around quickly. Seems like that's about it. I'm gonna start heading back. Luckily, by this time, I know how to navigate the city, really. As you see, we're able to get back here pretty quickly. So, I'm really wondering as to what other differences there might be. I'm not sure if that street lamp is always that raised as it is here. Of course, it all seems all the street lamps are kind of floating a little bit to me. I don't know if that was in the final version. I don't remember that. Might be wrong. Might be wrong about everything. It's turning away this time. That makes it much more convenient for me. That means free knocked out guard. Wait, what happened to that conversation? I didn't even hear a conversation, they just stopped it and walked. That was weird. I'm really curious if that happens every time in the demo or not. Probably have to retry this. None of these guys have keys. I think one of them had a pickpocketable key, if not both. Why is he standing there? This is kind of awkward. You're gonna make it hard for me to take care of everything here, huh? One more guard out of my way. You see, goblets still don't have their textures. So that's definitely an interesting thing. That seems about the same. I'm still interested at the fact that we didn't even get there we are, that way I can hide in here. Let the guards start patrolling this way. Have a nice way to take them out. And here's a nice patrolling guard.
What do I see there?
Thank you. Are you back?
Hey, what was that?
Hello? Nobody here.
Oh, well.
What's that? I'll start heading back the other way quickly before some guard comes down this corridor. That way we have taken care of this side. The only way a guard can come is forward. Not like they can try and ambush me from a side. A lot of this so far seems the same, beyond the missing textures and whatnot, have you? But I could be wrong, like I said. I'm here to show it off. You guys tell me, perhaps, what there is different. A key for that one. Let's head up here, take out this guard. More guard out of my way. I think all the guards below done being patrolling. Throw this guy in here. Definitely guard patrolling down below. One more guard on my way. And yeah, that water definitely looks funny to me. I think water in this demo just looks different for some reason. I could be wrong about it, but water definitely looks like it has a different effect there. Oh boy. Okay, head around to get that body. For me, there's no other guards really to find me. It's a matter of getting inside the place and dealing with everybody. Funny, I dealt with this a lot better than I did in my main playthrough. I showed how to deal with it properly. I'm definitely curious to see what happens later on, if we're going to have to go home or what's going to go on. We'll see, won't we? If this level's going to end up roughly like the other one, or if it's going to just be nice and allow me to play the entirety of this mission. Wait a minute, why is that torch flipped sideways like that? Look at that, this is flipped sideways, it should be that way. It's on that wall. That's interesting note. Both are faced that way. They should be facing forward. What's going on with the torches in here? Really? All these torches are facing the wrong bloody way. Or maybe that's the intent.
Someone's been having too much fun here.
So they didn't have their conversation even to begin with.
Who's the thief's here?
And there's that. One more of them down. The conversation range must be further than
too many imaginings.
The final game.
What's that?
Let's take these two bodies and move them somewhere more convenient. Definitely curious if this is just going to be like the final version or what. For most part, this one's a lot less grandiose than the Baffert's one was. The Baffert's one was very interesting to see different how different it was. This is pretty similar. No, it's not like I'm getting many surprises so far. Like back in Baffert's, I was getting a bunch of weird surprises thrown at me.
What's there?
I saw something. I'm glad it was nothing.
Nothing here now.
Any assassins didn't even notice the body being knocked out this time, luckily. That works. Yeah, models look somewhat different to me. Look at that. They're skinnier. That's definitely something different. Alright, let's head into the next room and knock out these guys.
Is someone there?
Alright, took care of them. One more room cleared out. Now we still have... Here comes the servant. Here comes the servant. Time to be bonked on his head. Here comes the servant. By morning, he'll be dead.
Who's there? Hello?
Mikey. And this is how the game originally looked, apparently. Back before it was polished back in Deep Gold. This is the original look of the game, people. Or at least how it looked in the demo. There's all that. One more room done! Okay, now we want to check out. There's someone patrolling somewhere. Ooh. Don't know where you came from, but I'll take you out. Add you to my little collection of unconscious guards. I'm definitely curious if I'm going to find all the loot in this level, since it's been a little bit since I played this.
I thought Quince and Jacko were on watch tonight.
The boss sent them on a special errand. Some fellow he wants dead. A thief. Name a Garrett.
I've heard of him. Garrett. No one to be trifled with. That's what I heard.
Not anymore if he's had a visit from those two.
I haven't even picked up any loot yet.
What's that? Who goes?
Right, two more down. And hide them in the little shelves here. A bit of loot finally. And this note seems pretty the same. Boys of Spare, all that. To do. Here's the secret way into the library, but need to go in here for these boots. Here's the loop. Definitely moving a lot faster than I would be in the normal playthrough. Not since after all, we should be used to this. I can go at more of normal playthrough speed for me. Oh look! Doors for the right! That was interesting. It was for the way vertically into the void. Oh yeah, door's buggy. Halfway down. The storage room's here, of course. Thank you. Come on, surprise me. Throw a giant hammer on somewhere. Not even a regular size hammer on, a giant hammer on. Oh yeah.
Is someone there?
And two more out of our way. Even care if the server got weird because of light proximity, whatever you call it. Because, well, there's a servant. Wait, that room's cleared. This room. Potion. It's this storage room key or whatever to there. Right, there's that corridor. Lay it down. Well, those doors are open now. Make life a lot easier. Right, upstairs we go. We'll take a piece of the bits of gold. We have this book. Ginny, all that. Wood Befford. This one is about the whole walled section of the city, the old quarter. Right in the haunted cathedral level. Right, there's some loot. Jump on to this, drop here, drop down here, and we're back down. Okay, now we want to head to the opposite side. Of course. Of course, of course. Unless there was a horse. Of course, of course. Funny when you think how fast these lockpicks are after playing leader levels and seeing how slow they are. Is that ring? Probably going to have the same amount of loot as the final version. The question is, can I remember where it all is? After a little bit of time away from this level. Unfortunate end, blah blah blah. Of interest out here. Alarm button. Tapestries. Gotta cut them down because they exist. Anything here? That. It's all this loot. 1730. That, like that, 100 more loot. Come on, squeeze through. Let's try and flip the switch again. Ah, that one's pinging a door to get through, huh? 2030. 2130. That's on the steps because I believe I've taken care of the guard that patrols here. If not, we shall have some interesting confrontations. Then again, do I really care in this version? Because like I said, I'm all about goofing around this one, checking out if mechanics are working and whatnot. Huh! There's no note there. Wasn't there a note next to that ring in the final version? There's no note here. That's an interesting difference. A lack of a note. I don't recall what that note in particular was about. I think it was about the barracks. Yeah, it was about the barracks. So So why does he know about the Burricks gone? Are there no Burricks in this version? Maybe not. There's no note on them. Right, 2380. We shall see when we head down there. Maybe there won't be any Burricks in this version. That would be startling. Overall, this level seems pretty similar, so I'd be very surprised if all of a sudden we get down there and there's no Burricks. Like a random surprise. We missing that. Don't worry, I'm coming with the food. Just leave me be! I know how to navigate these corridors. I know them like the back of my hands. I grew up in these corridors. Straight down here and through your metal door, where I'm curious to see where the Burricks are. There's this odd that the note's missing. I want to know if the Burricks are here. Notice I'm not hearing any pacing about. I'm gonna check down there. There are no Burricks! Ow! One significant difference between versions. The Burrick area is still here, but there are no Burricks. No wonder there wasn't any conversation between those two guards, because that would have talked about the Burricks as well. So it seems like, yeah, they completely cut the Burricks out of this level. That was like a surprise for those that played the full version. Interesting. The Burricks, of all things, was...
Odd noise.
Aha! Is it just me, or can I throw these like faster on the ground? It just seems faster. But yeah, I don't even have any healing, but I don't care! I don't have healing, but I don't care! I'm goofing around all here all day.
It may be time for me to move along now. Don't want to wear out my welcome.
Look at that key. That key is not really textured either. That's like a weird brown texturing. That's odd looking. 2655, that ain't all the loot. Overlord fancy, all that. That's interesting. There's still a bit of loot I'm missing. Any other papyrus that talks about Raputo, all that, Victoria, all them. Where's the bit of loot I'm missing? I'm trying to think. Huh. Where would the last bit of loot be? I'm surprised I'm missing a bit of loot. 2655. I'm trying to think. Also have to deal with the assassins, of course. Typically the assassins are... Ah. Which look as clunky as their friends. So where is the last bit of gold? That is the question of the day now, isn't it? For some reason, I always love saying question of the day too, don't I? Trying to think, what loot could I possibly be missing? If I knew, why would it be missing? Can't think of anything that I'd be missing. Picked up the ring, picked up the cloud stone. Picked up really anything that wasn't not in plain sight. Makes it really odd. Unless 2655 is the total amount of loot, but I don't think so. Let me look up Assassin's total amount of loot, just because I'm curious now if that's actually what Assassin's has. I don't think so. Let me see. Yeah, see, it's 2705. Okay, so here's the spare loot. Also, I gotta deal with the assassins outside. I do know that. And I have no healing. That really matters at this point, because we only have like a few guards, as long as we don't cause problems with them. And I just am kind of lazily goofing around. Right, there's one guard out of the way. Actually, now I have to go over here, swim across. Guard Numero Dos. Now I can shoot some moss top. Cross here. That way I can just get in here. Not the side way. That way I can get to this guy a little bit quicker. Without having to swim across the water again. Also trying to think where that bit of loot could be. 2705. What could I be potentially missing? I got the gold off his belt. Of course, that's where the assassin showed up.
Someone there?
There we are. All the guards taken care of. Now I can afford to come back in here and look for the loot. Because I am curious. What is missing? If, because this is a demo version, there is loot missing. That's the scary thing. It might have been like a pickpocket or something that just doesn't exist in this version. Can't be too sure. I probably should have checked beforehand. Making me more confident on my loot hunt and extravaganza. If I'm actually needing to find more loot or not. But I said it would surprise me because we found every other bit of loot. It would be if there was just some random no piece of loot missing or something. Everything else was. Trying to think what I could have possibly missed. Let me think, maybe it's in Lord Baffert's bedroom? Oh no, why it'd be in here? Could flip the alarms now, but I really want to. Not when I want to avoid Imperial entanglements. I'm trying to remember what I could be potentially missing. Yeah, I'm not even thinking of anything. Is there a pickpocket or something I'm missing? Not that I think of. But then what? By golly, what am I missing? So far this end's going worse than Return to the Haunted Cathedral went. How on earth is that possible? Ah! What the heck? What just killed me? what just killed me? Okay, so there is all the loot in this level, but, what just killed me? The game just decided to kill me randomly. I have no comment for what just happened there. I didn't even know what happened there. That was really random. Just random death out of of nowhere. Yeah. Well, that was interesting, to say the least. Let me think. Now that I have, like, a second, let me try and think where there might be potentially missing gold. No. It's all localized. There's only a few spots it could be. Let me try play again. Since, after all, I was trolled by Thief. Game decided, let's troll the player. Let's instantly kill him. I'm hearing the servant walk away, so...
That shot was meant for me.
Yeah, I'm upset at that. That was a ripoff.
Let's head back now.
These creeps are gonna lead me right back to whoever sent them to kill me. But only if I can tail them without them noticing me.
That was a door bug. That was an instant death by fireplace. Fireplace! Since when does a fireplace kill you? What even happened there? Somebody, please tell me. I need closure.
Stay. Is someone following us?
Did you hear someone?
This is...
just the wind, I guess.
I have no comment for what just happened there. That was messed up, to say the least. Death by fireplace. Something I did not expect to ever experience.
Thought I heard someone back there.
I thought I had seen everything. Apparently.
Nothing now.
The devil wished to show off that you could die by a fireplace. Not sure if that was a good feature. I vote against it. Oh yeah, I've never read the lockpick instructions. Of course, it is the same exact thing as always. Peek-a-boo. Now we gotta play this entire bloody mission again, even though I dealt with every single guard in the manor and shouldn't have had a single problem due to the death by a fireplace. Of all things in the world, a fireplace. That's when a fireplace is dangerous. At all! I swear the game was trying to troll me. It's the only logical explanation I have. The game decided to troll me and killed me as soon as I jumped towards a fireplace. It somehow recognized it as a door bug and murdered me viciously. I don't even know how to describe that. That was evil. It stinks because we were 2 inches perhaps for potential victory. But hey, at least you got to see something interesting. I bet you guys have never seen a death by a fireplace before. You can't say I'm crazy. I showed in video. I proved with evidence, photographic evidence, that you can die by a fireplace out of all things in the world. My God. One more thing to be paranoid of. Fireplaces. Do not trust the fireplaces and original Thief. At least that fireplace. Not sure about other ones, but that one is evil. I still have the question of, where is this bloody loot that I have yet to find? You know, I really should try and figure out how much loot it was, to try and think of what loot objects are that cost that amount. That's what I think I'm going to do if I don't find all the loot this time, is think what it could potentially be. Because that might help me along in my process of trying to find it. Because it's gotta be something stupid. Something I've dealt with before. I'm surprised I didn't find it my first go around. Usually I do. And I know for a fact that all loot's inside the manor. All loot's localized. It's one of the early missions when it wasn't localized. It is so weird to watch, especially the archer, how he walks with his bow. It just looks so odd to me.
So, these are Ramirez's boys. I think it's time I dealt with Mr. Ramirez once and for all.
Burricks tells me the hammers are gonna close down Craig's bluff.
Yeah, he's tapping you. Where are they gonna put the poor saps they grab?
Dunno. Toss them into a well or something. Anyhow, they just don't have enough guys no more.
Kinda sad. It used to be the power. Now they're just a bunch of guys wishing for the old days.
Alright, that's two guys down right away. Put these aside. Open up this door. Which way are you looking? Straight towards me this time? Inconvenient. There you are.
Who goes there?
No one goes there. You better not. I paid a watch for this concealment. Straight. Deal with that guy patrolling up this way in a second. First of all, I must carry him. Mr. Unconscious. There we are. Both guards up here are down. Make life a bit easier. Of course, life is never easy. You have to look for bloody loot that you found before, but yet can't remember apparently now. I'm trying to think what I could have missed last time. Most likely this time I'll find it and be taunted forever. Of course,
What's going on over there? Missing a pickpocket,
but I believe that was probably Ramirez who made him mad.
Must have nothing.
So that doesn't tell me too much. I'm trying to think of places where I might have had loot. Okay, all that's empty upstairs. Shouldn't probably dismiss areas like this when I can't find other loot. That's beside the point.
What's that? Who got?
Oh my god, out of my way. Make it easier walking down this way. See, they just go right on their patrols.
So wet. Molded.
Thank you. Conveniently there and let me knock you out. Sure. I'll take it. Take out you. Are you back? Pyrus. Not of interest there. See here, is there, I don't think there's anyone patrolling up this way. No, there wasn't. So I'm trying to think where the last bit of loot might potentially be that I didn't remember it. Doesn't help but trying to look around, you end up getting killed by a fireplace. That was not something that I was thinking was going to happen. I mean, of course, when you die, you don't usually expect it, but that was a really unexpected situation. Never thought a fireplace would kill me.
I thought Quince and Jacko were on board.
The boss sent them on a special errand. Some fellow he wants dead. A thief. Name a Garrett.
I've heard of him. Garrett. No one to be trifled with. That's what I heard.
Not anymore if he's had a visit from those two. Who goes there?
Over there.
What happened?
You're unconscious, that's what happened. Interesting, he commented after I knocked him out. And there was like quite a little bit of a delay before I knocked him out, so I'm surprised he didn't even search or care. Nah. He just all of a sudden realized his friend was unconscious as I knocked him out. Good job! Proud of you. I definitely think where there might be loot that I might have missed in the last playthrough. As if there is indeed. Yay for broken door! The locked way. All this is redundant. That's that. I'm trying to think where there might be loot. It's going to be killing me right now. Where that last little bit of loot is. This is most likely I'm going to end up looking for what the object in particular is. Just like these guys, I don't think talk.
I hear Grand Mont gonna put in some hammer-built security.
With the gears and blades and all?
Yeah.
Big mistake. Come home, forgot to pull the lever. Then the missus gets chopped to bits.
That'd teach him.
But yeah, I hear a patrolling guard coming up this way.
I saw something!
Oh well, sorry. Guess it was nothing.
Just the wind, I guess. Stop. Somebody following us?
Imagining things.
Just the wind, I guess.
Right, take care of this guy. I hear another guy patrolling up this way. Still an inconvenient spot for me, dudes.
Hello? Show yourself!
There's someone back there. Nothing now. Stop. Is someone following us?
Yeah,
it's him! Let's finish the job!
You hear that?
Oh dear.
Someone's searching for something, and we'll get the taff for it.
Oh, the guard out here. Careful! That fits the situation up after a crazy assassin situation. That did not go too well. Really twitchy assassin. Come here when he comes back. Hey there, I ate all your food. Isn't that crazy thief? Okay, now where is the guard? Oh, he's walked past, apparently. Interesting, where did he go? Oh dear. This is all we needed. A lost guard. Find our way around here. Pick our way in these rooms. So hopefully this time around we can do a bit better with finding the loot apparently around here. therefore of the killer fireplace of pain. If we have guessed, I'd be saying it. Wow, let's just go on with the torches here. Hello, potential fireplace of pain. I do not wish to mess with you. Because all fireplaces are now evil. You're off my list! Things I like. Ring. So I'm definitely curious how much loot I was missing last time, and that's what I'm going to be freaked out this time. Most likely, though, this time around, I'm probably going to find all the loot. Who knows? That would be interesting. Ugh, what the? What is going on with the geometry in this level? I swear everything is out to kill me. Help! The furniture's trying to murder me. I usually try to appreciate the furniture. I don't think I want to appreciate the furniture anymore. It's trying to kill me. The furniture is out to get me, people. Help me. What is going on? Killer fireplaces, killer bathtubs. I swear, this is a conspiracy. It's the entire conspiracy against me. They apparently heard I was coming to steal from this manor, and so they had the furniture out to murder me. How you make the game.
Enjoy it while it lasts, friend. His fatness will be back soon to make our lives miserable again.
Did you say peaceful ascent twice?
Down in the cellar again, counting his loot. I hope he stays down there all night.
Peaceful, isn't it?
A body! Help! Help!
It's a body! Help! Help? I'm quite confused. Am I supposed to yawn for help or what? I tell you, the furniture this time is evil. Please get me out of this demo. Get me back to the land of normal thief. But at least the furniture isn't out to murder me. I'm paranoid of jumping against, like, surfaces now. It seems that's what happened. But yeah, that's what I need to do to look for loot! Is that some type of, like, sadistic joke? What type of combination is that? You need to use it in order to find loot. If you use it, you most likely will be killed. That isn't fun. I see why. Luckily, the furniture doesn't kill you in the final version of this bloody game. God. This is one thing I'm glad I'm not having to be paranoid of. My God, this is a nightmare. I don't remember this in Lord Baffert's. Suddenly in this level, everything's out to kill me. Suddenly everything's a living terror. Why does that look wrong? But I dealt with both these rooms. I dealt with the room over there with the glue. I'm down here. This is going to be like the storage areas, which is completely useless, mind you. where we need from. Wonder if Garrett's that much faster in the demo that he just ends up accelerating everything and dying. Garrett 2.0. Much more cool in speed. Much worse in terms of efficiency or doing anything properly.
This isn't right. There's something wrong here.
Has anyone seen any deadly furniture that I must avoid? Right now I don't even care about anything else. Suddenly I've become pretty careless as I am quite paranoid this level. As it's become an evil death trap. You've seen firsthand how suddenly it's gone from a normal level to a level filled with murderous furniture. My god. This is not the level to be stuck in. Get me out of this hellhole. Get me out of this bloody hellhole. Why do I feel that's not enough loot? Why do I feel I don't know where the rest of it is? What the? What are you doing down here? I didn't knock you out? Well, fine. I shall knock you out.
It may be time for me to move along now. I want to wear out my welcome.
Thank you. 2480? What the? Where on earth is this loot I'm missing? Let me think for a second now. I only have 2500. I just lost another 100 somehow. Huh. I'm quite intrigued at the loss of loot I'm getting. Let me try and figure this out. Because there's a bit of loot that I'm missing. Oh, like 200 now. Or is 100? Could be potentially missing. It's even worse than last time. First floor, the only real loot. Definitely want to take care of these guards now. So I have 3 points of health. Mind you, not due to any guard, but due to bloody furniture. You know, the worst thing to get injured by it because it's absolutely miserable. Not like I have any problems with the guards. Oops-a-ree. Mind you, at this point I'm being a bit more reckless, but I don't care. Why? Because when you have to worry about furniture, you get reckless, as you've seen in my playthroughs. He's looking this way, I think. I'm trying to think where there might be loot that might be missing. I went up to a library and picked the chest, didn't I? I had to have. That's all I can think of, though. Unless I didn't go in the side rooms on the left for whatever reason, but I swore I went in there.
Who's there? Oh. Noise stopped. Guess it was nothing.
Gotcha. Alright. One last thing. We want to check for this bloody loop. Let me see here. All I can think of is that it's behind one of these little areas, because I'm assuming what I actually missed last time probably was those two coin stacks. Most likely. Ah, it didn't come in here. That could do it. 2705. There we are. Got the loot. For some reason, I didn't come in this room, really. Oh, I did it. I dealt with it. Time to get out of this hell hall before I die. Due to random circumstances. Due to a murderous... I don't even know what. But I want out. Murderous lampshades! Murderous telephone poles!
Maybe I should head back to my own neighborhood.
Of course.
Those fellas don't seem too friendly.
Of course, Garrett. Of course you'd pull that right now. Yep, head to the safety of bloody own neighborhood. Because why? Because I'm on 3 points of health due to a murderous... What even attacked me here? Bathtub? A murderous bathtub has forced me to 3 health! And now I'm forced to make it through the entire city. Luckily, I got a bunch of flash bombs just from that one chest, apparently. I only had one before that. Oh, quick! Uh-oh.
Who's there? Is someone there?
Gotcha. Have to move quick. This is chaotic. That's how you do it. Gotta react quickly.
So? Was that you?
My foot's up somewhere. There's a guard down there.
What's that?
Right. Take care of you, take care of you. What guy on the way? Your body down here. There's that. One more guy on my way. Start heading up this way, I guess. Got a staircase. You'll see I'm paranoid dying due to a random furniture. At this rate, that sounds like what's going to be a problem.
What I see there... Who's that there?
Identify yourself!
Okay, now that he's actually properly looking for me, he might not be stuck.
Come on now, come on!
Nope, he's still stuck. Ay, ay, ay! So that's the way by the ramp, that's by the statue way. Alright. The wind doors or something? Yes, it did. most likely I'm going to have to use a flash bomb on him. Because of how he is. In fact, I alerted him and he's stuck in an awkward position.
Who's there?
Ah! Halt! Try and catch this!
That awkward position.
What's going on?
Hey! You over there! Don't move!
That way we fix the problem with this guard. We're stuck in this play corner. Piling a collection of bodies. Right, let's head up this way.
Is that you?
Great. That's all I needed, more alert guards. The guard I can take out. Run around like a maniac, knocking out guard after guard after guard. Hopefully, one day, I can persevere and make it past this army of guards. Hopefully without losing my last 3 points of health. Oh, you're gonna make it awkward, aren't ya? I just wanted to return, but you couldn't let me do that!
I don't like this place at all.
Come on. Even if you're looking for me at words, as you get in that darkness.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Oh my god. Start heading this way.
Who's there? Is someone there? Seems quiet enough now. Oh well.
Come on, guy, out of the way. Pretty sure I know this guy. He's Mr. I'm stuck patrolling there. No, there is a route around, now that I think about it. We go down here and whatnot. Use all this to get around.
Hey, did you see someone over there? Oh well.
Hello? Show yourself. Nothing makes a noise now.
Phew! Well, this isn't chaotic enough.
Did that shadow move?
Oh dear god.
Don't see anything now.
Goodbye's out of the way. Quickly trying to move. Through the machine works.
Who's there?
That was awkward. Couldn't even hear him over the sound of the engines.
What's that? Stop right now!
tell you, flashbang mechanics are very different here. But yeah, very awkward way. I don't usually go this way. Mechanics feel somewhat off to me too. There we are. I got rid of this patrolman guard who gets stuck in there. They go all the way around, but we dealt with them without ogreing him this time. Just to show off how you can do that. Now we already dealt with most of the guards here. But I could afford to be kind of careless for the last few. We're home turf! And we exit the level. Alright. Was it just gonna give me a mission complete screen or something, or what? And it's gonna just give me that victory screen as usual. No cutscene, of course. 2705 or 2705 took 35 minutes, 33 seconds. 909. Pockets picked, locks picked 10. Zero backstabs, 49 knockouts. Well, airborne 2. 49 damage dealt, 7 damage taken, healing taken 0, innocents killed none, others killed 0, bodies discovered by enemies 3. And this one basically gives me the exact same screen as the one I got back at Baffert's, except I was able to actually finish the entire mission. So that one was a lot more fair to me, it made like almost a full level. Anyway! It's been long enough. I shall see you all later. Thank you for watching. And everyone takes care. Hopefully take care.